get these tanks across the bridge with his damn hole in the way. Take your men across and capture this bridge before the Germans blow it up.
Are you crazy? We'll get slaughtered.
That's not a suggestion. That is a direct order. Move out, or I'll execute you for treason myself.
Moving out.
Thank heavens.
See that? The bridge is still standing. Now get out there before they try it again. Move! Move! Move!
Oh, my God.
March 1945. With a bridge across the Rhine into Remagen secured, the Allies pour into Germany, bringing the fight against the Nazis directly to the Third Reich's doorstep. German forces in the Ruhr River Valley surrender as the Soviets reach Berlin. The once proud, seemingly invincible German army, which had sought to usurp additional territory from neighbors as far as the Soviet Union to the western edge of Europe and North Africa, is now forced to desperately defend and hold on to its own original homeland. The unconditional surrender of all German forces to the Allies, without which President Roosevelt had declared the war could not end, would not be long in the making. A world that had long been at war would soon be able to rejoice.
We had to prove that we was as good as anybody. We had to prove that we could handle tanks, gyro stabilizers, panoramic sights, all these technical things that belong in a tank. We shouldn't have had to do it, but we had to prove to America that we did it, which was a shame.
The guys that are doing this thing, they're just fanatics on it, which is wonderful. And the young kids can actually see what their granddads did, and it actually comes home to them. And it, plus, it keeps you thinking all the time as well. So I love that kind of thing. It's fascinating to me.
Against impossible odds, millions come forward to answer the call of their countries, their families, their lives.
Okay, really good. I do feel like you're rushing a bit, so you can slow down. You can slow down just a little
really
bit. And definitely, you can slow down on that last line, too. Against impossible odds, you can really take your time to set up the drama.
My father was in the Second World War. He was in the desert. He fought in the desert with the Desert Rats and the Durham Light Infantry. And then he went to Anzio. So, every now and again, he didn't talk about it much, but every now and again, we get little tidbits, little snippets of what really happened. And it fascinated us as three small boys. We just used to hang on to every word.
So we had the speed, we had the durability, we had the tools to work with, but we still didn't have the armor. We only had 4 inches of armor. The Tiger Roy had 12. And you couldn't knock him out if you hit him in front. So we learned ourselves how to defeat it.
Expecting me to be at the end of the game, huh? I'm kidding. No, I'm definitely wanting to say a few things. Well, these PlayStation 2 emulator games were a trip, huh? Some were pretty horrible to look at. Some, like this game, was really visually and runned really smoothly. I personally enjoyed these emulator games, even though it was a hard bitch to fix, let her alone even to let it work or run. And I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for just watching these series. These are literally classic COD games that you can only find either on the PlayStation or Xbox, like the original. And these games were always overlooked by the public. Like, some people who are like me, will go back and play these games and be like, damn, what a fucking good classic game. Not all these stupid fucking battle pass, all these dumb other extra bullshit that doesn't need to be added. It's just these nice, good games that are driven by true, so maybe not so much true, a little random bullshit mixed into it, but like a good story. That's mainly what some of these games are lacking. And the multiplayer back then was just barely a thing. It was just barely anything. So I just wanted to just say these things just because these games were so good. My personal favorite had been Call of Duty 2 Big Red One. I would always play that game when I was little, and I loved it to bits. This game was really fun, but really goddamn challenging. You might have seen it sometimes. Not sometimes, some parts. I like struggled really hard. But anyways, that's all I had to say. These games were amazing and extremely fun. And I'm ready to do the next series. And I'm not gonna ask. I'm gonna leave it how it is. I'm gonna show you what I mean. Maybe I might give you a little sneak peek or something. I don't know. But thank you guys so much for watching these my three favorite CODs that were part of my childhood. And I will see you guys in the next video. Okay, Cody, I'm loading into Minecraft. You gonna host or you want me to host?
I'm in my world. Hub world.
Can we create a new game at least?
It's been so long since I've been installed. What the fuck? I'm in this world, honestly.
Which world is it?
It's the old hub world.
Oh.
Miss it.
Wait, do you want to create the new world or you want me to?
This is the world we're gonna use, right? Man, I remember tearing down your house and putting this one in.
Imagine sounding like an old dude.
I haven't been on this world for so long.
I've been on this world making
something better than any of my stuff by making a huge thing in the like just cobblestone and dirt.
Yeah, sucks that Trent's not here though. Oh, okay. Do you want me to create the world or you create the world?
I created this world.
Fine, I'll create the world then.
Oh, I'll go create the world.
Fine, create the world and then invite me.
It is create.
Wait, you already made. Oh, okay, then let me join.
Get.
Oh my gosh, this is a lot of lag. Holy shit. Okay. Where are you?
Me?
Yeah.
Where are you?
I'm by spawn. Did you not spawn here?
No.
What the fuck? What do you mean? You know I'm my game?
It says world doesn't exist.
What? But it's your game though.
I know.
Try joining then, since I guess I'm in your world.
No. You're not.
What do you want? See, can you join or no?
No.
Bruh. Are
What are
we
you
gonna play
doing?
Minecraft? Why you can't
No.
join?
Oh, why don't you join?
You're lagging a lot, by the way.
You're lagging.
What are you talking about? You're lagging. Bruh, what are you doing? You're lagging too much.
You're lagging.
Cody, just join. Stop lagging. Sounds so bad. I can't even understand what you're saying. Cody, just leave the party and join back. Oh, I don't think he's gonna be back. Oh, spoke too soon. Cody, can you hear me?
What's so funny?
Whoa! What is that noise? Cody? Hello? What? Did he disconnect? Fuck, I shouldn't kill myself. Damn it. I swear, him and his poopy fucking Wi-Fi. Well, I guess I'll just play by myself. This is not a bad world. I wonder what this world has in store for me.